Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to ESL One Cologne 2014. It is the day four of four. It is finals day here at Gamescom 2014. After yesterday's fantastic quarterfinals and the group play that took place on Thursday and Friday, we yet again report more records have been broken for Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Yesterday, more than 320,000 of you tuned in to set a new world record for viewership of a Counter-Strike game. Fantastic matches as well. Today, we're going to concentrate on the semi-finals and the grand finals. You can see on your screen right now, eight teams battled out yesterday. We're now down to the last four. $250,000 up for grabs, of course. And it's time to find out who goes through to the grand final at our third major in Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Our first match is going to be amazing. You have to feel it. With the teams involved, it's going to be epic. Let's bring them out right now. First up, a team who yesterday said to me they can go all the way. They can win the trophy. They have what it takes. They have the best in-game leader in the game, and they have the frags when they matter. Please welcome Team Dignitas. Our second semi-finalist is a team who are no stranger to semi-finals or indeed the grand final here at any of the majors that have happened so far. The original champions of the very first DreamHack CSGO Championship. Please welcome Fnatic. And before we get into our first game, as ever, let's check in with our analysis desk, ably hosted by the wonderful Sir Scoots.
Thank you, Red Eye. And tonight, today, this morning, this afternoon, somewhere in the world, we get to be joined by Sean Garris. Thank you very much for joining us, buddy.
Not a problem at all. I'm glad to be here.
So before we get into breaking down this first matchup, we want to chat with you a little about your own tournament run. Obviously, last night's game, epic. Record-setting viewership-wise, which is awesome as well. A little over 320,000 people watching that game. Bittersweet finish on Cobblestone, to say the least.
Yeah, it was a brutal finish. I'm not going to lie. We had a pretty rough night because of that. It's definitely a bitter pill to swallow. I'm not going to lie.
And again, same placement from Poland, fifth to eighth place. Also, Nip sent you home there. But it seems that you guys are firing on maybe a little bit more all cylinders with the addition of Shroud. Yeah. Obviously, brand new, very excited sponsor in Cloud9. So it's kind of like we're seeing a new North American squad out of you guys.
Yeah, I mean, we're a totally different team now than when we were in Poland. I feel like we're a lot more ready to play the Europeans. We have a lot more fast-paced game that they have a hard time recognizing at times. So it kind of catches them off guard on a lot of really key rounds, and we're stress buying, and we're knowing where to get the picks based on how we watch the demos. It's working really well for us. So yeah, we're doing a great job thus far, but we need to work harder and really get over that hump to get to the finals next time.
And another shift that I think was very apparent this tournament is, you know, you have traditionally been the strat caller. You were the strat caller in Poland, and you've kind of now shifted to more of an advisory strat caller or a strat caller in certain situations, and Semphis has kind of taken over that leadership. Yeah. And we can see it in your fragging, your scout use, all those things. Crazy stuff.
Yeah, so Semphis started taking over calling during our SIVO season online maybe a couple months ago. And the reason being is just because we wanted to have a more loose play style that gave the players more freedom. Whereas when I call, it's a lot more restricted and player has to smoke here, stand here, be here at X time, leave at Y time. And it just wasn't working with our lineup. So we decided to switch our play style altogether and have Semphis call. And I'll put an input on which site we should go to and kind of which strat we should pull out the book. However, it's largely Corey's decision now, and he's done a fantastic job, and I'm 100% behind him in the leading he's done lately.
And what about Cloud9, your new sponsor?
Oh, yeah. I mean, Cloud9 has been excellent. Jack has been by us the whole time, so Jack runs Cloud9, and I mean, we've been with him for 2 weeks now, and I can honestly say that every day he's, like, worked his absolute hardest to make sure that we're happy, and we're just all so stoked to be here.
That's great. That's great. Any questions you want to ask him before we get into this?
No, I don't ask any questions. I just want to say, like, you guys have been a breath of fresh air, like, seriously. I think everybody in Europe's been like, actually behind you guys, despite the whole European NA rivalry. I think you guys were really just put on an awesome show. It says everything, I think, that you've been involved in probably the three most entertaining games here, and three upsets as well.
Yeah, I know, right?
And as for that Shroud kid, man, like, where did you find him?
I don't know. We found him, like, in a stream. We literally went to Twitch, went to the highest viewers. No, I'm just kidding. Shroud's been around now for a couple seasons, and he really just sprung onto the invite scene solely due to his stream. So it's kind of a motivator to up-and-coming players, honestly, if they can just get their name out there, stream some, and if they're good enough, they'll get noticed. Yeah. And that's what happened for Shroud. He was good enough, got noticed, and here he is at a major just shortly after.
And ripping it up. I mean, made so many clutches. I saw him clutch a 1v2 against Get Right and Forest.
Was that the one in Kabul?
Yeah,
his reaction time to the situation and his awareness of his surroundings is definitely in like the top 5% of CS as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, and I think the online tag can be put away when you talk about Shroud now.
I think
he's earned his stripes, if you will, yeah.
In fact, we should find the people who were saying that. Where are they today?
Let's get them out.
Hi, haters.
All right, let's jump right into it. So obviously, first matchup is Fnatic versus Dignitas. Both, Fnatic finished 5th to 8th in Poland, and Dignitas 3rd and 4th place, you know, the perennial 3rd, 4th place team. You played Dignitas, obviously, upset them, if you will. So we don't know the maps yet, obviously, we'll get that in a few minutes, but initial thoughts on this matchup from both you guys.
I'll lead here. I think Dignitas is favored on all the main maps that people are used to in Counter-Strike GO, so like the Dust 2, the Nuke, the Inferno. Probably, Mirage kind of gets a little bit dicey. I would probably give the Fnatic the edge there.
We actually have our veto coming up, not to interrupt you guys, but this will make it even better for us. Let's see what we got here.
They're going to pick Dust 2.
Interesting. I mean, I think that's a good pick, actually. Fnatic have been struggling on Dust 2 lately, so I think that's, again, smart play there from Dignitas.
I kind of would have liked to see them pick Inferno right there, though, to be honest. I think Dignitas has a great Inferno CT side, and I could easily see them getting 11 rounds no matter what. So
Fnatic have picked CT on Dust 2, which I think is interesting. They're starting probably to slightly weaker side on that map.
I think that's what a lot of teams now at the pro level are doing, though. They like to start CT side just so that way they can play with a little bit
overpass.
Of aggression and looseness.
Wow.
Yeah.
So Fnatic picked overpass. It's funny, you were just talking about that off camera, weren't you? How Fnatic kind of favor these newer maps that have come in.
Inferno's the 3rd map.
And Inferno's going to be the decider. So I probably, and Sean may agree with this, I think that's actually a really good matchup for Dignitas. I think they've got maps that they are easily capable of beating Fnatic on.
I think if Dignitas wants to win this best of three, they need to win this first map. They're going to have a really hard time on overpass.
Yeah.
The one scrim, I think we scrimmed overpass like twice, I believe, in our boot camp. And we did play Fnatic, and they literally ran us into the floor. They beat us 26-4, I believe. They have really great smokes for the B site and a really slow, methodical default that works all corners of the map. So it'll be interesting to see how Dignitas can deal with that, because I don't think they played overpass yet.
They haven't. We were talking with Henrik, obviously, when he was on the stream the other day. And Henrik was saying that, you know, he felt that overpass was the better of the two new maps. They'd put a little bit of work into it, but not a lot. And what I like about Dignitas is, I think as well, they will look at it. They do look at a best of three holistically.
Yeah.
They're not going to panic that, okay, we've got to play overpass. We can beat them on Inferno, no problem. So I don't think they're going to be too stressed about it. But that's definitely going to be Fnatic's map.
Yeah.
Also, keep in mind, Fnatic upset Virtus Pro on overpass 16-9.
Yeah.
Here at the tournament. So they probably have some confidence in that map. This is going to be interesting, to say the least. So let's talk about the very first map. Obviously, we know that it's going to be Dust 2, Fnatic CT side. Initial thoughts on it?
It's going to come largely down to the AWP battles between Fetish and Device on the Dignitas side, and then JW and Olafmeister on the CT side. I like to see Fnatic run the double AWP setup, where JW is AWPing around mid and Olafmeister is kind of swinging around the map, kind of looking for aggressive picks. They're known to be very aggressive CT players, so I really am excited to see the CT sides of both teams and just see the aggression throughout the map.
I think Crims is going to be hugely important in this particular matchup. I think he's a very important player for Fnatic, even though he doesn't quite catch the eye, like maybe Olaf does with his picks. The reason for that is they often put him as the lone player on bomb sites, so he'll hold like B by himself. And it's all about how he stalls and how many kills he can get. and they've got complete confidence in him that he will do that. And I think he's had a great tournament here. That confidence has definitely paid off. I don't know if you've assessed his
performance. Yeah, Crims is definitely one of the best support players in the game right now. Whenever I watch him, he just makes really smart decisions. And like you said, he's able to stay alive in situations to allow teammates to rotate to him. And oftentimes, because of that, they have the number advantage in bomb sites because he's able to stay alive, which is vastly important.
And conversely, I think for Dignitas, you're going to have Device really step up on this. We call this the Device. I mean, he loves to just run around. He'll pick up the AWP and go mid if he's feeling confident. He'll boost up short and just run out with a rifle and get two picks. I think he'll be a big entry fragger, a big presence in this game.
Something that I really think is important, so when we played Dignitas, I did a lot of research on their Dust too. So something that I saw as a hole in their game, which I'm not sure if Fnatic might see a hole in their game, is their mid to B is kind of weak. Dignitas likes to nest three guys in the A bomb site and nest two guys in the B bomb site, which is makes it really vulnerable to a CT spawn smoke and just isolating two guys in the B bomb site. So I'd like to see Dignitas, and it's ultimately on, I believe, Zippix as the rotator to play spawn more and help out the mid B, because I think Fnatic will abuse that. Pronex is a great in-game leader and he will find that hole.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. I mean, that's one thing we should definitely highlight. We've got two great captains here, two great in-game leaders. Pronax is very good at calling on the fly and reading the game. I think probably that might even be a strength he has that's slightly better than Henrik, than Fetish. I think Fetish is more like a playbook caller. He comes up with the ideas going in. He has very rigid tactics. And, you know, he likes to execute a game plan from the start, depending on how he's reading the game. Pronax can kind of wing it.
Exactly. So when you watch Dignitas, what you'll see is they'll often have a strat out of spawn, or maybe they'll see a smoke and they'll go into something. However, if you watch Fnatic, they may be in an execute and completely decide to ditch that strat altogether and go somewhere completely different. And that's largely due to Pronax's ability to lead on the fly. And we like to call it mid-gaming in America, where you're just kind of controlling the middle of the round. And he's definitely one of the best as far as the in-game leaders go.
All right. That being said, you know, it's do or die day today. These guys have all got themselves $22,000 at least, but the next jump is to $50,000, right, for second place. So that being said, we're going to throw it to our casters this morning. We're going to start you off with Tossbot and Pansy. Take it away.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Almost thought of saying good morning, Vietnam. It's
It is early.
We are, honored to be here for what is going to be just a great day of Counter-Strike. Pansy, your thoughts going into this. How excited are you?
It's an unbelievable game. These two teams having different routes to this point and a lot to prove. You know, Fnatic have been constantly questioned after their phenomenal win at the DreamHack, and then following off that, slumping a little, then changing players up, coming back stronger, and G3 for Dignitas must have been heartbreaking in the semifinals. They looked the strongest team there, but didn't quite make it any further. So it's a big proving point for both of these teams, and I can't wait to see it.
Fnatic, yeah, I watched their game against Na'Vi, I watched a couple of games through this tournament. They haven't done it the easy way. In every game, they've had to fight. In every game, they've maybe allowed their opponent back into it at some times. Dignitas, on the other hand, have been brilliant. They, you know, what their performance yesterday against Epsilon was just domination in pure motion.
Yeah.
But that's what happened to them at G3. Now, this time around, they won't face off against Virtus Pro side, who seem to have their number. So maybe that will favor them all the way through. On your screen, you're looking at Fnatic, and now the Dignitas side there, as they've had their prep. They've been here for some 90 minutes or so, and none of them made it out to any attendance last night. They were all in bed early.
Well, there's a lot on the line. They have to do this. These two teams are well aware of each other and know each other's play styles, and we're going to see that coming into this.
So here we go. Fnatic versus Dignitas, starting us off on Dust 2. We will then be moving on to Overpass. We'll get your thoughts on that later on as we get to that. That's going to be phenomenal. And then Inferno, if we need it. It's the semi-finals of the ESL 1 Counter-Strike GO Championship, $250,000 to be won right here this weekend. And Lauren, why don't you take us away as we are about to get into the first round.
Yeah, looking to see how these guys open up. We were talking actually with Devil Walk a little bit outside and mostly about their pistols and how they actually struggle picking up those first couple of pistols. They've really not got a lot in the bag in this tournament. They built off the back of that. They're one of the comeback kings in this so far, but the start has not always gone their way. So I'll be interested to see if that trend follows into that first pistol round coming up. And in an interview, I think it was with Fetish actually on HLTV recently, he said that they've started to call it a little different now. They've got new additions to the lineup. Pronax has adjusted a little to make account for, you know, the new players. And it might be a little harder to read, but I want to see if Fnatic can finally break that bit of a bad trend they got themselves into, not being able to really pick up much towards a pistol. So I think we are just getting everything ready. Obviously, a lot on the line. They don't want to come into this with anything other focused towards winning the game. So,
well, the problem is, if Fnatic do have a soft start, or if Fnatic do make any mistakes, Dignitas are a team that absolutely punish them.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah. Clinical in that sort of aspect.
This, yeah, Fnatic play, every Fnatic game is really exciting for the exact reasons that Dignitas are so good. Fnatic make exciting games because they will let teams in. Dignitas don't let anybody in. Over to you.
Oh, it'll be interesting to see how the T-side do. Obviously, being Dignitas here, they'll have to bring some of the pace at least. And it looks like a 3-2 split to begin with. Nothing too crazy there. But JW and Olof, looking like they want to go for an early challenge. And as you said, Fnatic, the aggressive side, happy to get a little bit of a taste of the action. And it will be Device there with Dupree. Nade comes out and back go the CT side. Olof did receive a good chunk of damage, but he does have the armor. It's not the end of the world. And the thing that I think it was Sean Garris was saying there, that they've got a little bit of a shaky way of playing through mid, but they've chosen short to work up towards, and Pronax met them on every step so far. So 3v5, not great for Dignitas here. And the confidence from Fnatic picking this up would be brilliant. Finally to break that little bit of a slump in the pistol rounds, and let's see if Dig can find that final bit of execution. Flash will come in. Olof is waiting. He's going to find Device, takes him down, but AZ continues to bully through towards A. Now JW on the side. Zibnix pushing up towards the ramp. Not going to find too much. It's a little bit shaky in the mornings, clearly. And maybe looking for a bit of a Kelly moment for himself. But JW will find Zibnix. He will find AZ. And Fnatic get the first pistol round.
Just what you want to start the morning. You've had your Weetabix and you're ready to go. Fnatic pick themselves up the pistol round, and they'll be looking to add as much to the scoreboard as they can. Watch Dignitas on this game yesterday against Epsilon. This was what was Epsilon's map choice. And whilst Dignitas did win, it was interesting to see how they offered up. They were just so dominant throughout this map, so hard to pull things through from there. But for Dignitas, they were very much kind of a read and react attack that game, much in the same way that they defend maps as well. So let's see, as it'll be frags traded. There is JW with his P90 dispatches of Device, but AZ returns the favor, and Fnatic will be angry to have lost a man relatively cheaply. So there are still a lot of Danes down at long A for Pronax to rattle off a few shots towards. Fetish will sit waiting for anyone daring to kind of come up behind and close those Dignitas players down along. And now they've pulled themselves out of there. Flusher, who'll see action coming across up towards Catwalk. He wonders whether there's any more, and he doesn't spot Fetish. Dupree will come through, and what a nade from Pronax, like a basketball shot as it swooshes in. A follow-up there from Flusher as well. And Fnatic have themselves the round with only one man lost.
Sudden bit of discipline just kicking in there. As soon as JW went down, it seemed as though, I think it was Pronax and Shiner just fell right back towards the A side. Like, those CZs, we don't want to mess with them. Let's just take this very carefully, very cautiously. Want to build off that initial pistol, and they got it. Brilliantly done. Not perfectly clean, but still, they work with what they got there. So 2-0 to Fnatic, leading so far into this one. Dig not really making the impact, but it looks like they might be going for a little bit of an all-in, and let's see if it's going to pan out, because Crims will be waiting. The flash, the nade comes in. Flusher gets three, and it's a little bit of a quick round, to say the least. I don't think AZ can do much here, and there we go. Flusher cleans up with a four-piece coming in to the third round. Yeah, they were eco'd, but he dealt with it well, and it cost them very little.
Perfect conversion there from Fnatic, having won the pistol, but now it's the first buy round, and Fetish will wield the big bad gun, and we'll see whether that can open some holes in that Swedish defense as he sits waiting for the hit. And look at Crims' health. What a shot there. And we'll see whether Fnatic have anyone else to dare to make that jump. So, nothing doing for Dignitas there. And if you look on the overlay map, you can see there, completely uncommitted. You've got AZ waiting to see if anyone pushes aggressive in tunnels. You've got Dupree and now Device in mid, and then Fetish roaming with that AWP, waiting to see whether they can get the entry in. They'll happily do that. wait to see whether they can close out any area. JW with the smoke down on double doors will just fire off a few shots, and that'll delay anyone pushing in there as well, because no one's going to want to be going in blind towards where JW will be setting himself up for, and it'll completely allow him to escape that area. Fetish almost about to duel with Flusher, but Flusher is held back, and Fnatic haven't been able to push out, except for that one man on Long A getting a few shots down there. They don't know anything about this Dignitas side at the moment. It's JW who is down there. But now Pronex will see action. There's nothing to block this push coming in. Just one name being tossed over on towards Fetish, but suddenly Pronex has got Angry Dane charging him down on the A site. Tipnix gets the first JW down on Long. Olafmeister comes in with two. Make that three. Great play from Olafmeister before Dupree eventually ends him. Flusher avenges the loss of his beloved Olaf. And now it is a 2-on-1 as Zipnix has to go over. Collect the bomb, but look in the top of your screen is that we are down to a mere 5 seconds. Flusher knew that and will wait to capitalize. Bomb did get planted though from Zipnix. Fnatic with a minor chink in their armor, they'll be happy to take the round, but a hole there allowing that bomb to get planted in the first place. But it goes to 4-0. Fnatic, good start to the day.
Brilliant start to the day. And I always get a little worried seeing Zipnix running around with that AK. The man can just undo situations so well, but dealt with perfectly by Fnatic in the end, then locking it down. But as you said, bomb plant did go through.
And that's what allowed the weapons.
Big play coming out there from man, not too far from your screen. So let's see what Fnatic can do this time. Dignitas still a threat here. They're still building up, maybe testing the waters. As you said, they're not committing too drastically, but we've already seen a big opening come through. Francis Nate did find AZ, but two replied back. So Dig do have the player advantage. Device is low, but it looks like Dig are looking for that A execution. They've worked it out. They're building into this. Dupree's got down Crims, and now just JW and Flusher here. The smokes, the execution was on point, but JW watching that cross. Zipnix, smart move there. Just going to drop the bomb across and get that one down and tick. And we know the impact of just getting that plant got them back into this round, and be able to do the same, and I think Fnatic know that this is not a round they're going to get back in towards. And you got to say, Dignitas, for the first couple of rounds, seems as though they're just trying to find out information, constantly getting it through, and in this round, it just kind of worked. The smokes were on point, the flashes were on point, even with the opening kill going to Fnatic.
One decision, one mistake can cost so much in this game, and we go back to that last round, that bomb plant cost Fnatic this fifth round, and that's something they're going to have to live with. They're going to try and get away with two players up, and Flusher wants to make this as expensive as he can, and helps himself to the frag of Dupree, and will drop them down. Because forcing the rebuys when you got players who would... Actually, they got the two guys who had Galils, I think. nevertheless, 4-1 to Fnatic. Great start to the day for them, as we mentioned, and they'll have to, for the first time, the rebuy. But look at the desk, Fnatic. Flusher, not died yet in 5 rounds. Excellent play from him. He's able to buy for his teammates, and he's the one that had to pay the count, as we see JW just rattling a few shots. Dupree will now move out in towards Long A. And Chef, frag down the chasing Olafmeister. Olafmeister not protected by Pronax, and Dupree gets both of them. Awesome play from him. And now it's JW that's going to have to come around. First shot hits, device down. He retreats back down and towards CT spawn, looks for AZ, and AZ is barely alive, but in fact, he's a little more than barely. He has 49 health, and the two Fnatic players will sit in CT spawn. Together, they are stronger here, and they may find this a very hard retake, and they're going to decide it didn't happen. But the difference between the two sides was that A-long push there. You saw Pronex completely retreat, completely unhelping Olafmeister. Unhelping's not a word, I've just made
we're gonna
it
make
up.
It one, it's fine.
Down to Long A. Whereas in a Dignitas side, the two guns are always there to help one another. And that was very individual play that eventually cost them both their lives down to Long A.
And I, not worry, but you've got to wonder, will this start affecting the confidence of Olaf? Will it start affecting the confidence of Pronax here if they're winning out and losing out mostly in those little 1v1s? Olaf can be such a big player kill-wise, you know, into the kind of JW region sometimes for Dignitas. If he starts getting shut down constantly on Long here and he keeps getting worked through, then we might see a repeat here, because I was talking to Anders about, you know, how the Dignitas guys like to play this, and They do have a little bit of a tough time ahead of them, but they have a little bit of a curtain towards the semifinals. But at the moment, they're kind of getting over that, and they're building, and they're getting back into it. And every single time, they just seem to know how to play Fnatic down to the absolute letter. Fetish will go for the challenge, and he just claims JW, and the confidence alone to go for these shots is just going to be building up for Dignitas. And now, Fnatic a little on the back foot. However, Pronax's nade could have done actually probably more damage than it did, but Zimnix took the brunt of it. Fetish looking for the follow-up towards mid, but really to be found, but Flusher is there and waiting, evens it back to a 4v4, but the flash is coming in perfectly. Zipnix is going to land that every day of the week. Now the splashes, the smokes come in, cut off the CT side. The A rotates are going to be struggling here, but the flash off the back. Pronax comes in, gets one down. Oh, quickly dealt with by Device. And now B is now guarded by one man alone. Prims in pretty much a 1v2 here. Bomb is down. I think he just got a glimpse, but Fetish. Fetish goes as well. Crims, big play there, dealing with what was coming through those B tunnels. Now Device left in that 1v2 situation. The rotate not working out for Dig. Maybe Device can save something. A lot of time still on the board. He's got time to work with. Smoke goes down. He was already quite low, however. 47 HP. Crims and Olaf sitting perfect. Device. Interesting positioning. Feeling a little confident, backs away. Good choice there as the fire starts to burn. You've got to be a little cautious. Fnatic not taking this lightly either. Good matter of time though, and here we go. Execution comes in from CT's one through the hole in the wall. Oh, not going to happen. Crims locks it down, and they dealt with that so well. But Crims on B, just a complete stopping force then.
Really interesting round. I mean, first of all, Fetish starts it off with JW. You lose your AWP, you lose the person who brings all the information to it for Fnatic, and then they have to suddenly think, well, we've lost someone all along, they might try and push in towards A now because they know that we're weak. No, they went through double doors and they won the first frag. Excellent counter flash, then took out the man who was there, and then in on B, awesome 1v1 play, got the frags. And they left it very late. That Molotov that wasn't meant to land where it did stopped them from coming in two different angles in towards the site and almost cost them the round. But Fnatic get themselves a three-round advantage and back to winning ways for them. There was enough money in the bank for Team Dignitas to buy. And actually, just at the end of that round, last move was to pick up the AWP that was on the floor in B from Fetish. And look what that's left Fnatic with. Olaf Meister and JW both able to offer this one out. And that is part just to mix up the strategies and part the threat that Fetish brings in the form he is in this tournament right now. So what do you do? Awesome play from Flusher, dropping Dupree. The moment that smoke went down, Flusher knew there was something to shoot at. And shoot at it, he did, albeit somewhat blind. Olaf Meister tries to take out Fetish, but Fetish again wins that battle. And expect CJW to have to move to counter what's coming up from long A now as Flusher pushes out. Fetish is there again, and the big man strikes twice. AZ gets the next one, and Fnatic are down to just two men alive. Will contest, or will perhaps be on the hunt for Fetish. And let's see whether they can do that. Oh! There was a good opportunity there for Crims to basically come in and assassinate Fetish, but he wasn't able to do so. He's going to try and support JW now as JW goes looking for it. He had the one shot, and he didn't take it. Zipnix might peek again, and he will call in Fetish the reinforcements. And AZ is going to try and catch them unawares as they chase down. The bomb will blow any second now. Will AZ be able to take out this AWP? Big opportunity, big moments here. One AWP aside could get lost, and Crims helps out JW, and it looks like Fnatic will get away. Both sides escape with an AWP.
And I'd love to find out the impact play of what Fetish is doing. So in the round prior to that, he won the 1v1 with JW along. JW then went mid, and we had the other AWP in the hands of Olaf, I believe, on the site. Fetish still took down Olaf regardless.
But and it's two frags that round as well.
Big play coming out from this man, just mentally maybe forcing Fnatic to play a little bit of a different style, but I'd like to find out from the players after this match how that's affected them in this, but still, nothing going on too much yet. We are seeing actually a little bit of aggression from Pronax pushing straight up. He's got a Device in front of him, gets the first, looks for the second, Zipnix standing in his way, he's taken down Olaf, so a bit of a two-for-one exchange, but Pronax is not done just yet. He carries on, gets Dupree down, gets AZ down. Wow, the confidence alongside this man is unbelievable. As Zipnix, what can you do? You're not even really a minute into this round and your teammates have been slaughtered. As already Crims, we know this man likes to hunt down anyone remaining. they got two last round in the afterplant. Zipnik's up in hand, trying to stay alive, but there's a lot of time to work away, and Crims will put him to bed, and what a phenomenal round from Pronax.
Awesome stuff from Pronax and from Fnatic. Whoever made that call to just rush up and mix it up, they were not expecting that. The moment they waited for the AWP shot to miss, the moment that those scopes were down, they were up and at them, and that was fantastic. And Pronax actually did it all himself, because if you consider, he did a lot of team damage to the one guy that charged up with the Famous with him and eventually died. Look at the situation that's forced as well. Three CZs for Dignitas, who lose AZ, and Fnatic know that with CZs in hand, they need to not engage this one short. They'll fall back into CT spawn and take them at range, where their weapons are far, far superior. So Fnatic looking great this morning, and there will be war. JW, what a hit up to Fetish. Device, the last man standing down, and well, I've seen three people try that jump this weekend, and two have done it quite sensationally.
Wow, they thought LDLC had a little bit of the limelight. They're like, well, we fancy a bit of our own, why not? And 7-3 being that scoreline now. Fnatic are building, they're looking confident. Dig, though, back on a bit of a gun round. Fetish going to be sticking, I think, with just that Deagle. Maybe going to try and build up towards the AWP in a little bit of time. But some unbelievable shots have been landed in the last couple of days, and that is one of them. Call it skillful or whatever you want, it does look good, but still. Time around, 11th round, but you see a little bit of Dignitas building once again, taking their time. Clinical players, clinical team, struggling to find that final push. Fnatic certainly been meeting them on every single front here. As Device Dupree look towards mid, couple of smokes, couple of flashes. Fnatic doing the same, holding them back, trying to offset the timing that Dig may want to bring. And once again, we'll be seeing Zipnik's toying with Long, but I don't think he's actually hanging around this time. And is it going to be that mid-execute? I think it is. Dig are cutting off the complete A players, leaving the last two for Fnatic. Tucked in on this site, Flusher has got one. Crimson must deal with who's into... Oh! I hope he notices. I don't want to give away anything in this situation, but I think we need to watch this man right here, right now. Four players for Fnatic looking for the retake. Crimson, dangerous positioning. JW will find Device. Three now left on towards the site. Here we go. Zipnix takes down JW, and regardless of the brilliant play then, it doesn't matter, as it looks like Dignitas are holding on. Easy, not going to be able to manage it, but Fetish will locks them down, locks them out, and the B play in the end through mid worked again.
So Crims got caught in two minds there. He was, you know, placed fortunately courtesy of the smoke, and the problem was that he wasn't quick enough there to be a surprise player. He decided to wait for the rest of his team coming through, and you could see when they flashed it, they just threw kind of the expected flash in there to make sure that no one could come through the tunnels. He either had to make that decision quickly and go big, and essentially it was go hard or go home, and he went home. 7-4 Fnatic. This has been a great way to start the day. Zipnix will push in, gets himself fragged by Olofmeister's Famous, and you see Fetish uncommitted at the moment. He is the one who will pick up the bomb, and JW with the AWP about 2 seconds too late to catch the glistening light off the back of Fetish's head. That flash that'll just, oh, JW gets a hit onto Fetish in the end. That smoke just falls slightly short, gives Device a little opportunity. Look, Dupree down. JW just picking up frags left, right, and center, and you can see that small yellow dot that is so crucial to this one. Device now will come through as he makes his way through A, has no idea. JW still rattling on frags, and oh, Fronax will get semi-fortunate to get the frag onto Device. Device thought he would pick that one up, didn't, and now it's all on AZ. JW will complete, I think, a hat-trick of frags and did not lose a single man that round. The bank of Fnatic will be looking good, and the confidence themselves equally so.
Not sure what else to say. I think you summed it up perfectly. Confidence must be sky high with Fnatic going to round 13. Dig, I wouldn't say struggling, they've just not really had that final bit of execution. They've had brilliant rounds and then just got locked out money-wise, and you can see that the CZs are back in play. AZ and Dupree deciding to go with them. This time, maybe going to take a little longer. Normally they head down towards long A. This time they look a little like they want to switch something up, but JW meets them at the doorstep, takes down Device. So the aggression, the confidence, we know what the CZs can do, as obviously do Fnatic. As we know, Crims does like to occasionally roll with it, and Crims, the man himself, on B, locking it down again. AZ left in a 1v4. I think he knows what's going to come, and there we go. Fnatic, clean round again, only lost Flusher there. And all in all, it's just Fnatic looking good this morning.
They're looking great on their CT side. But lest we forget what Dignitas can do. So looking at the, let's bring up the scoreboard and see what the teams are looking like. So Flusher had a great morning, but look at the spread on those top four players. Only two frags, three frags separate the top four players of Fnatic. They're all shining right now. And Oak in mid, Dignitas moving quickly here. Olafmeister has got incoming behind him. JW pushed out on catwalk and just didn't get someone. But it'll be Fetish coming through. Fnatic know exactly what's coming their way with JW down there and having lost Pronex there. But can they do anything with that? Because Dignitas are coming in with a vengeance towards this A site. It's Flusher, gets the first and the second. But Fetish will eventually shut him down. Fetish coming up now will toss over that bomb towards AZ, who'll go towards him, and we're in a 2v2. AZ and Fetish will make the push in now. Fetish has three frags this round, and JW has had some big hits to make, but the rotation is alive and well in the shape of Fetish, and Fetish will have said to AZ, just stay alive, unless someone challenges you, like Crims, for example, and I will come and help you. JW is going to find himself between a rock and a hard place. Tries that hit that he did just moments ago, and it will fail. There's Fetish taking down the wounded soldier that was JW. Great play from Fetish. Got four frags that round, but AZ also just bought time. Didn't commit to the bomb plant, bought time for Fetish to get into that play.
And I can't help but almost remember back to the Cloud9 NIP moment. Forrest buying the time there on the site to allow Getray to come around in that final so important round. And just the team play alone, the trust that Fetish was going to make it around in time to support AZ there came perfectly into place. But once again, the danger strikes, and the fact that Prodax is feeling aggressive. He's feeling like he wants to do what he did before. Last time, I think he picked up near on three kills from this, and he looks like he wants to cause hurt again. Device is low, but AZ through the lower B tunnels, cutting Fnatic in half almost, but it's a very aggressive final round between these two, and at the moment slightly in favor to Dignitas with 4v3. Pronax is in such an unorthodox place. Can they predict it? Do they still know he's around here? Can they negate it completely? Let's go towards B. 1 minute left to make these choices. Fetish still with them, still leading the way. As Pronax pulls back a little, that smoke maybe calming them down, saying, okay, let's start playing a little bit more standard here, see where they're at. They've lost vision of Fnatic, Dignitas, and they want to regain that. JW still holding on. I'd love to see this little 1v1 go down again. These two have been going back and forth consistently. And 40 seconds on the board. It's going to be some commitment. Maybe Zipnik's going for a little bit of a cheeky little play towards A, but the hit, I think, might be coming down towards A. Zipnik's play they forced him away. This is perfect stuff. Zipnik's is a flashing beacon of bait completely and utterly, and it's drawn everyone of Fnatic over towards A. He can die here and be fine with it, because right now in B, that is the execution from Dignitas that is sensational play. Fetish knew exactly how Fnatic would respond to that sort of stuff. Just stack out the site, go and challenge. And they just got B for free. Bomb down. Can they now secure the round? JW waits. Device tucked in. Flusher looking for a way through. Clock's ticking. Fnatic knows that. They can hear this ticking away faster and faster. Flash has now come in. The push has begun. Fnatic are in on the site. It's just finished now. 1v1. Fetish with the hat trick. Stunning, stunning play. After a perfectly played out round, he finishes with that.
Fetish just wins two rounds in a row for Dignitas. The one before he got four, that one he got three. Awesome play from that. Fnatic will be kicking themselves because it was 9-4, and yep, it finished 9-6, and both were winnable rounds for them. They were almost played that perfectly. Zipnik's, as you mentioned, was the bait, but the smoke that JW laid down on B forced, I don't think Dignitas were 100% confident that they had a free site to come
no,
in.
No, they took their time.
Because they were coming in blind. But in the end, the clock was against them. They had some 20 seconds to go in when that smoke was laid down, so they're just like, well, we have no choice. We can't go anywhere else from here. And they charged in, and 9-6 is a very different scoreline to the way that half could have ended.
Fnatic will be over the moon. They had a very positive start, but this will be a feeling of lost opportunities for them.
And I have to ask the question, I think in most interviews, most articles, anything you read about Dignitas, they enjoy the CT side. They're a team that it complements extraordinarily well.
Well, they do until Fetish said what he said on stage to Paul yesterday.
It's fair enough, but results alone back the fact that they've always played quite nicely on it. The defensive style, the smart style, it plays into their hands, you know. And the one thing I think Heaton brought up a long time ago, the one issue with when you start on the CT side is you're always waiting, you're always the one responding rather than one making it happen. You're always going to be a little colder. But now they've had the T side to kind of build themselves up, get warmed up. You saw the play coming out from the boys on your screen right there. They can play that CT side very comfortably now, I think. But we'll have to wait and see.
Fetish rocking all the party tricks to open the bottle of water with the lighter.
Oh, I've learned so many tricks in Germany. Like, I swear to God, Germans have every single trick under the kind of sun to do this. But it's nice to see Fetish being able to pick it up as well.
Cameraman just peeking over the wall into the Fnatic thing. It's all right, Mr. Cameraman. You can look, but you can't touch. And the Dignitas side are, well, full of confidence. This, Kappa, remember, though, is Dignitas' map, as Mr. Kappa joins us this morning. And it will be, if you are just joining us, it will be overpass for map two. So still a twist in the tail for this one. All to play for here. Fnatic 9, Dignitas 6. Pernik just sat in the middle looking for whatever information the world has to offer. It'll be a three-man Fnatic push. Device is going to be the one who can see action first and foremost as he makes his way across. Oh, one hit! Say goodnight, Pronex. And he will retreat back with that in his pocket. Goes in for the second one. Olivmeister down. And what can you do when Device is hitting those shots? Crims does eventually down him, but Device can sit quite comfortably now for the next 1 minute and 10 seconds, as Dupree loses a fair chunk of health. This CZ, interestingly, is Fnatic will regroup. They're a man down, and it's going to take an individual moment of brilliance to open up this Dignitas defense on this A side as Zipnix comes through. Flusher is the diversion down on A, and so he tries to open up a second hole, but Crims will pick up the first. JW has been lost. Zipnix comes in with one more, and now it is Flusher or bust for Fnatic as he goes 1-on-3. All from low health. This isn't impossible, but it isn't going to be easy either. Fetish down, first man out. Look at the clock, though, that has a part to play here. And the lack of the bomb has an even bigger part to play. Flush is going to have to go for this one. Does have a nade to help him out. He's going to look for Zipnix down to the bottom of the stairs. And the two of them come together to give him the wall of fire. And it will be Fnatic who, oh sorry, Dignitas who win the opening pistol round of the second half.
Fnatic back into the trend of not liking to pick up pistol rounds, it seems. But anyway, 9-7. If it goes the way it can, which we often see, it should be pretty much even. But then again, there's always a threat of the CZs. The T side always has the chance to come back. It always allows for that. And that's maybe what Fnatic can go back on if it does get a little close here. But let's see what they have in store this round. The man I probably wouldn't want to meet at the moment is waiting in pit, and he says hello to one. Finds Olaf. It's a good tag. Zipnix now comes in with the double, and this is Dig just being clinical. JW does find one, but end of the day, it's the least amount of impact we're seeing right now. Flusher getting a little device. Everyone's so cautious, everyone's so careful, don't want to lose anything. And Zipnix picking up four in the end there. But all in all, only losing out on Fetish. No bomb plant for the T side. Dig will be happy with that.
Great play from Dig to convert their pistol into one. Can they convert it into two on what will be a Fnatic CZ round? And we'll see. For this Dignitas side, you know, lots been made of their CT superiority, or just generally across maps, but also a lot's been made that when the semi-finals come around, they wobble. And this may be the biggest tournament of them all to not wobble in. So they charge in towards Device, and that smoke's actually going to help him perfectly. I think it was thrown by Fnatic, but it's going to help him. He just moves in. None of the CZs can focus on him. And as they quickly charge up towards the B site, the objective there is get that bomb down as they will go in. They're outgunned and soon to be outmanned. But that doesn't matter. I'm completely wrong. They're not going to be outmanned here. They're two men to the good, and they've been able to pick up the Famasis. This Fnatic side are staring down a victory here as they will push in, and it'll be Zipnix who eventually has to concede. The smoke does its job. He's got no information. Fetich says, you know what? We cannot win that. And Fnatic not only will get away with a bomb plant, they'll get away with two Famasis and M4, and it worked by hook or by crook.
Whichever way it works out, however it comes to play, those CZs are changing this game so damn much. You know, let's be serious here, the P250 is not exactly weak itself, but those CZs do allow for that sort of style, and the smoke was brilliantly placed in the end, as you mentioned. But it just allowed Fnatic straight up in towards B, and we see this execute time and time again, but when you lock it down to this, if you take it into real kind of aspect of what the map is, if you lock out A completely with the CZs and you just focus on to B, it's fairly close range, and those CZs can do real damage. And Fnatic just knew that, and they ran with it. Right now, we will be seeing Fnatic at 10-8, turning the tides a little earlier on, and now into the 19th round. Dig will be a little bitter after that one, but I'm sure they'll be able to manage. So far, Fnatic just taking their time. No need to rush, you know, haphandily. They've got some brilliant talent on this side who can open these sites up. JW being one. Olaf, when he's on point, is stunning in his play, but at the moment, just being cautious, and you can't blame them. Dig have been very good at this so far, testing the patience. Now 57 seconds left. Fnatic, see if they can draw anyone out for a little bit of a challenge, but interestingly enough, no one really playing in mid here for Dig either. They're happy to leave that up in the air and then focus on holding the sites and then maybe rotate if necessary, but at the moment Fnatic are starting to make that play towards mid. 30 seconds left. Fnatic need to make this move now if they want to get this one going, and here we go. Anything that stands in the way could really offset this timing, but Pronax finding Dupree will be brilliant, but Zipnix is there this time. Smoke doesn't hold him back as much, but still, this B play has come out time and time again. AZ falls, and Fnatic have got it down to a T here, leaving Fetish and Device to try and undo the pretty much the dire situation they're in, but Fetish so low, I don't think he can really challenge much, and I think Device knows that as well, so they're going to back the hell away. And Fnatic have worked out a way to get Dignitas worried on the CT side now.
Well, they just pushed through. I mean, that time, that round was pretty slow because neither side had a great amount of intel on the other side. They couldn't find one another. And then this push through double doors with the smoke into CT has worked two rounds in a row for Fnatic. And the man that's in there has just been completely isolated. In the last round, I thought the smoke would actually benefit the CT player because it would nullify the short range CTs. CZs. This time, it just was perfect for Fnatic. It allowed them to waltz on up into the B site, and they now have a three-round advantage on Dignitas' map, and will be feeling pretty good. Look at the bank of Crims and the bank of Pronax. Both are overflowing with cash. And on the other side, it is far from the case. Nades to help, but CZs and the picked-up weapons from the last round, not good. And also, we'll see whether it comes into play. Only the one kit. So, Device will push in. The way Fnatic have gone, those nades would absolutely come in handy for Fetish here, because pushing into long A is just going to line up for that. And they obviously don't know what we know, but now we spy Dupree and Olafmeister. Of course, such is the way of CS these days that just as Fnatic begin to build momentum, it would be to the enjoyment of the casters for Dignitas to disrupt it and throw a spanner into the works. Nades come in towards the A side. It will be Pronax flying down onto Fetish. Awesome play from that, and taking the only kid out of the game. Fnatic get themselves the next one onto Dupree, and now it will be Zipnix having to come and avenge. Collects himself Fetish's weapon though, and Hoffmeister comes in and assassinates AZ from the back. We're on a 2-on-4 with a bomb down and two players with weapons. They'll hold this one out. Fnatic will march on to 12 here, Lauren, and this is looking good from the Swedes.
They're just locking out Dignitas every time. Smokes, flashes, nades, keeping him at arm's length throughout the entirety of the game, whether it be through CT or not. They just constantly zone out plays, and their B execution has been on point. at the moment. Zipnik's the only one standing. I'm not sure if he's even going to get away with that AK, but...
You know, tournaments can be won or lost by just having good days. Fnatic have had okay days in this tournament. They've not been good, they've not been bad. But they might just about to be able to have a great day.
It's on the verge of being so. 12-8, first map in this one. Fnatic's slightly more aggressive style, maybe, depending on individual performances. It's not going too badly, to say the least, at the moment. Dignitas back with weapons, however. Maybe they can work this one out. Maybe they need to adapt a little. Maybe just mull it over and try and work out what's really working for Fnatic. At the moment, Fnatic have liked running down that clock. I don't think I've seen a full A execute from Fnatic yet with weapons, so I'm interested to see if they actually build towards it during that mid to B play. Has been their favourable strat, but we've yet to see what they can bring towards this A site, but I think we're going to find out very, very soon. Zipnik's shoulder peaks away from short. I don't want to stay around too long, but he has caught enough of a glimpse. He's got the information. Fnatic might want to reconsider their options. Nice little smoke will just shut them off for a little bit longer. Buy a little bit of time for the rest to start considering rotating from B towards A, but Fnatic still able to rotate if they fancy it. Device getting taken so low as well. See if AZ and Dupree can lock down this mid push. It's been something that's been a consistent pain towards Dignitas, but Flusher pulls it off again. AZ goes down, and just Fnatic one by one working this out. Dig knew where they were this time. There was not a lack of information. They had it down to a T, but regardless, Fnatic are now starting to push towards A. Device does stop JW, but Device being so low, he's going to be careful as Crims comes through on towards Long. Flusher through CT, leaving just Dupree alive, locked out at B, and it's another brilliant execute from Fnatic, but this time on the A site.
Yeah, that one really worked, and it was interesting to see them go A because it offers us the kind of ability to compare that against Dignitas's CT side against Epsilon yesterday. Yesterday, Device was just the king of the catwalk. Epsilon played a number of kind of repeat strats where they would just try to mush up catwalk, and Device would push out to the top of the smoke, to the top of the lip there, and just find himself a frag. And that happened two or three times. And then once every so often, he would push all the way down catwalk. Most of the time, it was passive. Device hasn't been able to do that. The game has not played in towards his hands. You saw Zipnik push out, try to replicate that round, but he had to fall back. Also, that stack that Fnatic ran where they put JW up helped immensely. Gave them the kind of confidence that no one's pushing down B tunnels because he could just look over there and put them above that they could shoot over towards where Device and Zipnik were. So just all around, Fnatic had an answer to Dignitas there. And gotta say, this is probably a result of just watching yesterday's game against Epsilon and saying, if we're going to play on dust, we know how they're going to do it. And it's been very good. What's interesting, though, is that, I was about to sing Fetish's praises. I was literally about to say, Long A has been very difficult for Fnatic to execute against because Fetish is just in beast mode this morning. But
he only had a CZ.
He only had the CZ.
There was five of them. Like, he's been good, but we're putting a lot of, but you have been absolutely spot on. And even if you turn it around the other way, when he was attacking this, how many times did he take down JW? I think he forced JW to maybe readjust where he was, but Device in a good spot. CZ's this time being overpowered by Fnatic's very own. And
now, what's interesting was when Fnatic lost one or two rounds in a row last game, they would push, was it Flusher or Pronex, up through mid. And they just changed it up on their CT side. Dignitas don't have that plan B. Dignitas don't seem to be able to change it up when they need to just put the cat amongst the pigeons. And that's why they're staring down on what's about to be 14-8, leaving them just two rounds of a cushion left to salvage their map. It's overpass next, ladies and gents. Remember that.
It's a worrying time for Dignitas. Gonna be suddenly getting the pangs of don't tell me this is G3 all over again. These kind of semi-final moments where they start to have those couple of issues sneaking in, the thoughts of don't tell me we're gonna choke now. I'm hoping they don't, because let's be serious, some of their rounds have been magical, beautifully played out, but they've gone to the arguably better side if you look back at their results, and it's not really showing through just yet, but things can change. We've seen it happen before. We've seen games turn on a dime, but at the moment, Fnatic look very strong, very clinical, very focused. And, well, Flusher has just not been missing so far. He is on an obscene scoreline, even on this half, 7-4, 16-6 on the prior, but Those kills have been coming in very big for Fnatic right now. As you can see, 23-10 overall for that man there. Heads and shoulders above everyone else, but at the moment, we'll have to see if he can find anything this time. 1 minute still left into the round. Not a time to work with. Olaf starting to look. We know Fnatic like this mid to B. The smoke is there. Zero, so it's all good. The peak, he does look through, see if the push had begun. Didn't catch anything. Finds maybe a slightly more passive hold here. Olaf still looking. Are they trying to draw these guys back? Where are they trying to push them to? Fnatic still in mid. Flusher still at B. They haven't really adjusted beyond this. But we know they can do the fake plays. We know they like doing that. Zivnik's pulled it off perfectly prior, and looks like a bit of a push on all fronts now. Flusher going peak in a B, and that's going to draw the attention across, but the push is happening now towards A. It's going to be Dupree to stop the B split, but Device will have to deal with players that are coming their way on towards the A side. Not going to get the first, as Olaf will find Zivnik. He's going to back out and look for another angle. Not going to get it on the second time of asking, but oh my word, Device, you're going to want to start hitting these, buddy, because that bomb is now down and ticking. Fetish moving in for this, and I worry because you've got the likes of JW still up and Olaf, but right now Dignitas retaking this site one by one as JW now on the site gets taken down, and finally, Dig break Fnatic streak.
Yeah, so Dignitas, a lot of good stuff happening there. They made the call at the right time to say, right, we're not going to hold this site, let's fall back. And that's when you saw the AWP coming in from Device. And then just Fetish again. The man, I mean, his stats put him at 17 kills, which doesn't quite justify how hard those 17 kills are done. But if you look at those kills in relation to the rest of his team, thank you very much, that shows just how strong that he has been. He wants to win. There is, might sound stupid, but he is playing like a man possessed this morning. He woke up, he was, I want this tournament, I want that $100,000. JW says, yes, so do I, as he pokes through the long A gates and just dispatches of Zipniks. Fetish was there. Fetish would have been the prize, the real scalp that you want in a morning like this. But he'll go through, and Fetish is a master and commander, but he is also very dominating. He will be fuming that the rest of his teammates aren't up to his level this morning. We'll see whether he's got something to offer as Dupree skips around the gates. The Fnatic players concealed by the smoke. JW with the AWP, looking to see if anyone will just show themselves, and Dupree stopped just short of giving a limb for JW to attack. So he's treats from the box. Two players in B. And interestingly, the diversion up towards B in the last round offered nothing for Fnatic, because the player was instantly dead. Yes, he got a trade, but he was instantly nullified, so it wasn't much of a bait in any way, shape, or form that caused that Dignitas defense to think twice. Fnatic down to 28 seconds now as they begin to execute. Pronex pushes in, gets dropped by Dupree, and Fnatic may have waited just a touch too long on this one. Dupree now goes in, AZ gets himself the kill. Flusher is going to have to go big, and didn't. And it was, well, just a little bit here, there, and nothing anywhere else for Fnatic in that B assault, but they've still got JW, and he's got Dupree and Device on low health. If he can finish the job, but he can't. And Dignitas just pull back another round, just about. Good Fetish. Still time for a joke on the high five. I'm going to go bottom with my high five. You go top. Don't do it on the side. Don't confuse me.
But I've got to ask the question. Did you see a mid smoke coming out from Fnatic then to block off CT? Because I didn't. When they started to push early. Okay, there we go. I was kind of a little curious as to why that wasn't in place when they did start to begin their push. Usually they do start very early, but JW and Device exchanging the tags, they're taking each other quite low, 29-35, and at the moment Fnatic starting to get a little close on the scoreboard. Dignitas building up, catching up, looking it down. 1 minute and 14. We know Dig likes to play the sites. They're not going to go out for these crazy challenges, but we are seeing a little more aggression towards mid, but Device will be waiting. Oh, he catches Pronex as he tries to get down towards CT, and the execution for the T side might be lacking a small piece in the puzzle, as Zipniks will be waiting, finds Olaf, comes around, spots JW. Oh, he just about gets away, as now JW and Flusher might need to kind of reconsider their options here, but that play from Device stopping half of the kind of plan coming into effect.
Stopping all of it, because the smoke was seen into CT spawn. The idea was that he would jump down, he would take out, I think it was Zipnix that was there, and that would be that. He would then rush on up to B, everyone would live happily ever after a bomb blew up. But not in the slightest. It was a single play that ended the round and then made everything that much easier. Fnatic have been able to evade for some 25 seconds. I'll be very impressed if they get away with both these weapons. Flusher the most at risk from Fretish, who will push out in 15 seconds. Fnatic are guilty of playing into Dignitas' hands somewhat by using the clock as much as they have done. They could do with one round just to mix something up. So we'll see. That they did try to revert to form on this one and just hold out B. Interestingly, there you saw Dignitas didn't actually want to chase out those guns because Dignitas don't have that much money themselves. So they didn't want to risk losing one gun of their own.
You've got to start asking the question, is there going to be those rounds to play with to be able to switch something up for Fnatic very soon? That scoreline's getting quite close, and you'd hope maybe at the start they go, oh, let's just try something out here. Let's do something a little different. But at 14-11, you're going to have to start wondering, we need to lock this one down. We need to start playing the very best and not risk anything.
Very much so, JW. Oh, if only you'd known how close he was. Interesting, they bought the Galil for Olaf on this round, and a handful of nades which have now been used as they dwindle away. Fnatic are going to lead with, I think this will lead with Zipnix trying to take out the stack. Not sure whether he was aware it was coming, but the follow-up Molotov will definitely dispatch of them. And it is Krims who waits. Krims comes around the corner, and Zipnix takes off his head. And now Device with the AWP. Oh, JW gets the better of him. And Device, you just thought that one was playing right into his scope, but no, JW bests him. And now it will be 4 versus 4 at 14-11 with 50 seconds to go in this round. Fnatic raced into a great position, but they've struggled to get to the finishing line as Dignitas have put up their guard. And it will be, again, that push, but Dignitas have gotten better at holding on to CT now.
No smokes, I don't believe, with Fnatic.
Nothing to hold back Dupree, who will have a clean shot. The question is, will he be facing it? It's JW and Olaf Meister who combined to down Dupree. And here we go. They're going to push in with AZ the man to next stop them. But JW bests him as well. Awesome play from him. Zipnix now with Fetish will go 2-on-4. Bomb planted at B. And let's see what Dignitas have here. This would have to be something very special from Zipnix as he loses Fetish. And Zipnix knows that will not be possible, or will it? Dignitas gets the frag onto Pronex. He's going to come charging in, looking for more. He just wants kills at this point, and Flusher will prevent that. And it is going to be 15-11 Fnatic. And Dignitas know they can't. I mean, Zipnix had to go for it in hindsight, because otherwise it would be match point. So it was all in. He couldn't hold out. But 15-11 the score, and look what's left.
Interesting weapon choices, to say the least. A Deagle, an auto sign, but that is the most mixed kind of bag I've seen in a while. But regardless, Fnatic start off well with Olaf finding Zipnix, getting the better spawn there, and just going to run with that AWP still. Sticking with that. Now the
four Fetish was always going to tag someone who might die, follow him into a risky position so he could get that gun instantly.
Yep, now Dig having to respond. Device struggling to land these shots, it seems, towards the A site. We saw him before, but they did retake. The bomb is yet to go down. Are they rotating off? They're rotating off of this. Olaf found two! Big play there. Three kills this round. Bomb is down on A. They secured mid. They know where these two are. Fetish is going to fall, and Device finally landing the shot. He's got four more in his way, and I think he knows this is a near-on impossible situation with Olaf round the backside, four to get Dust 2 under the belts of Fnatic.
Great play from Fnatic. They pick up Dignitas' map, and they do it in some style as well. Big questions to be asked on that Dignitas side. We move to Overpass for the second map, which is Fnatic's map, and it is smiles all around. Let's see whether our analyst desk are smiling. Scoots, how are you?
Tosspot, I am good. Thank you for asking. unexpected. I mean, Dignitas' choice. also a very strong team on that CT side, right? Yeah. Now they head into Overpass, very much a Fnatic pick, and so far at this tournament, very much a Fnatic map.
Yeah, what you saw early was a lot of catwalk aggression from Fnatic, and I don't think Dignitas really had a way to solve it. You saw Pronax pushing up middle from catwalk one round, running back and still getting two guys in the lower B tunnels. I mean, they were just abusing Dignitas all over the map. And then T side, they were just abusing the mid B late game. They knew Dupree rotated spawn one round, caught him off guard. Really just excellent mid gaming by Pronax and the Fnatic squad.
I mean, I don't think you need to overanalyze what happened there. Fetish is your top fragger.
Yeah.
You've got problems. It's as simple as that. The other players didn't really turn up, and Fetish was having to make three mans, four mans, just to get it to 9-6 at halftime. That's a bad, bad sign. One of the reasons Fetish has these young guys around him is that they're going to do the heavy lifting for him, and they didn't do that today. And this is one of the reasons why they've choked in semis in the past.
Yeah, exactly. They need Device and Dupree specifically, really stepping up and getting stringing together 2K, 3K, 4K rounds on important gun rounds. And their aim was on some rounds, but other rounds they were just kind of missing shots. Like one round we saw Device at long A, missing a couple op shots. It's not really characteristic of them at all.
Not at all. And I got to say as well, Fnatic are people that usually have trouble closing out games. I remember at Gfinity, to give you an idea of this, Devilwalk will hate me telling this story, by the way, but they were 13-2 up against Infused. It was their last game of the day. So he went and called a taxi.
Oh.
And he came back, and it was like all of a sudden 13-12, and he was like, guys, what's going on? We need to get out of here. They do have a lot of problems bringing it over the finish line. Not today, though.
Yeah.
Thought they might have had a wobble, but they did what they needed
to
do.
It's something that this lineup has really improved on over time. If you have an aggressive team such as our own, or even Fnatic, or Dignitas, you have really aggressive players. If you go up big, your players start getting more aggressive. And when aggressive players get too aggressive, things can really crumble on you really fast. And I think that that's something that Fnatic struggles with. I'm not going to lie. They did a great job this game really stringing it together and piecing together a good finale.
Yeah, and Olaf and Krims were just insane again today. Like, we highlighted it at the start, how Krims was going to lock down B. Absolutely had it, shut down for business today.
Yeah, there was one round, a really early round in the first half, I believe, where he was back of B site. We saw him hiding, and he kind of shot a guy in the side of the head, moved to the left, he played the smoke a little bit, killed a second guy, and that was a huge round for Fnatic. Something so small as that 2K, you can't really see it on the scoreboard post-match, but probably won them another two rounds at half.
All right, so Overpass. Obviously, you know, they get one ban, and Dignitas did ban Cobblestone. Makes perfect sense. Now, the only advantage is they can go look at that demo. If they kind of thought in their mind, okay, well, Fnatic's probably going to let it go through. They beat VODS Pro on it. That might give them some insight, you know. And what we talked about a lot was, you know, Taz and gang really hammered that A site over and over and over, but unsuccessfully. So going into that, maybe Dignitas has maybe figured out a way to break that contain, but still, like, that's a risky, I mean, again, makes sense they banned Cobble, but now they've set up a possible 0-2 with losing on Overpass.
Yeah, Fnatic definitely has a really strong Overpass. So something we noticed when we scrimmed them was Olaf will work that, like, stair area with a door almost every round, and I mean, he does a lot of crazy stuff there. I'm not going to spoil it or anything like that in case they're listening right now. But I'm really interested to see how he's going to go about this match, because it's all in his hands what he does in a round. It's not designed out of spawn or anything like that. It's completely off feel. And that's something that the Fnatic players work off of. And I can't wait to see how they play this Overpass map.
Okay, they got our stats ready. Backtrack just a little bit, and let's talk about these stats a little bit.
Yeah, well, there you go. I mean, that's what we highlighted there. Fetish at the top of the frag charts for Dignitas. Now, I'm so pleased that Henrik has stepped up his game and added some fragging, but that he'll be disappointed. He'll be sad to be at the top of the frag charts, because that means the aimers, you know, they're not doing the hard yards, the heavy lifting, as I said earlier. Mm-hmm. And I've got to point out as well, I thought that was JW's best performance for Fnatic in the tournament so far.
Yeah, absolutely. JW's op, and we even saw Olaf busted out on that last round where he got that 3K or maybe even a 4K. So JW really had some huge rounds, so like 16 op kills. That's massive. That's a complete match swinger.
And you can see as well from the heat map, where the lockdowns occurred for the various sides. Fnatic had B pretty locked down pretty well, I think. but also as well, like Dignitas were able to shut out long often, but that was all down to Fetish. Fetish was playing there and he was able to stop them getting through. But in mid and in B, and as you said, controlling short as well, Fnatic were actually dominant as the, you know, as terrorists.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they just did a great job all around the map, and terrorists, they completely dominated Dignitas, who's typically a very strong CT squad.
Well, that's what I mean. That was the other thing I think was really surprising. So Dignitas have an incredibly strong CT side. They prefer to play it. Like Henrik sat here and said that the other day. He doesn't consider it a T-sided map. He considers it to be very open, and he's worked on his counter-terrorist. But today, that wasn't evident at all. It was, you know, it was like watching a very different team. And I mean, do you think they can possibly come back on Overpass, or are we witnessing another Dignitas choke?
I have never witnessed Dignitas on Overpass, and they didn't seem too confident about it yesterday, but they only have one elimination, and they chose Cobblestone. So I think they're going to have to really have big work out of the Riflers here. They have four great Riflers on their team and an amazing leader, so I think they can win on a close-range map like Overpass. By no means is it impossible for them to win this map.
Yeah, sorry.
Well, again, speaking of Overpass, I think you guys practiced it more. Obviously, I heard that you literally, how well you did with your lack of practice on Cobblestone last night. It was amazing. But your thoughts on Overpass as a competitive map?
I think Overpass has a lot of potential. I really do. It just, when we came here, the Europeans were so far ahead of us, and we only had a couple days to play the map. We only had a couple scrims to play against, and we just weren't ready to play a team like NIP on Overpass, especially what we saw them do to Hellraisers, and Fnatic is in that same league. I'm not sure if Dignitas is, but these European teams are really prepared on Overpass. It's really interesting to see how they've used boost at long A, how they've opted at B and A. They pushed in close quarters, a lot of rounds using smokes. So we'll see a lot of really cool things this map, I think.
I mean, I got to say, I'm looking forward to seeing it. I haven't watched a lot of Overpass coming into this. I tried to watch a few games to brush up my knowledge for some analysis. But I agree with you. I mean, I wasn't a fan initially, but I can see the potential there. Yeah. And it's something a little bit different.
Yeah.
I will also add, though, I will feel so sorry for Valve if Fetish's team go out based on Overpass. He'll have something to say about it, right?
Yeah. Definitely.
And I think one of the cool things about it, and we've talked about it, like similar to Nuke, forget the bias of CT on Nuke, but the elevation change, right, of the bomb sites. Most of the maps that we play are very linear.
Yeah.
And you've kind of got that difference in this map as well, which kind of mixes it up. That's, like you said, need to tweak some stuff for sure.
That's something that I'm really scared about for Dignitas, because if they haven't played the map a lot, something that's going to be really confusing is the sounds, because people are going to be all around you, and if they're not really used to where those sounds are coming from, they're going to get completely dominated here. I know Fnatic is used to the sounds because we played against them, and they're fantastic on it. I hope for Dignitas' sake they are too.
Yeah, it's going to be, obviously, their work is seriously cut out for them.
Yeah.
I got to be honest as well. I think after the great games we had yesterday, incredible series, I mean, you guys, again, you know, got to be mentioned. I think it would be a real shame for the tournament if this was a, you know, 2-0 blowout, because this had all the hallmarks, the potential to be a real classic as well. Yeah. And we've had that consistently throughout this tournament. So I'm hoping it does go to a third map, but I got to think that Fnatic, in winning Dust 2, have probably done enough to win this tie.
Yeah, and keep in mind, if Fnatic does blow this, Dignitas will start CT side Inferno, so they better end it here.
Exactly. All right, that being said, thank you guys very much. We're ready for the second map. Could be do or die. It is obviously do or die for Fnatic. They might go home. They might move forward to that third map. Back to you, Tossbot and Pansy.